female are very, very slim. So there we go. So if you get into Theravada, it's all down to me. If you don't, that's down to me too. All right, lovely. Okay. So hello, everybody. It's nice to be here, and thank you for the warm welcome.
Is it clear, Mike?
Is it clear enough? Is it loud enough?
Just about.
My voice will get louder as I speak.
I mean, there's always a possibility of raising it to speak in front of your mouth, but I shan't interfere.
No, don't feel. That's good.
I don't want to holler at you.
You're a natural behind the mic. Wonderful.
I'm just a good actress. Okay. So I believe it's a 2-hour session. So what I thought we'd do tonight is I was invited to offer a prayer. Now, I wouldn't normally do this necessarily, but I thought it was a lovely suggestion. And I know you normally have your own prayers that you do. But I defaulted to the Buddha's words on loving kindness just because they're so beautiful. And there's a little tune that can be done along with this. So I'm going to do that just for the sake of not droning everybody. If you don't follow the tune, don't worry. Just maybe repeat the words along with me, or just imbibe the meaning, because the meaning is the most important part of it anyway. So I thought we'd do that, and then have about maybe half an hour, 25 minutes of guided meditation, followed by a little Dhamma talk, and the subject today is happiness is the path. Okay, so not only is happiness the goal of the path, it has to be there every step of the way. So we'll talk about how to make that possible and notice happinesses that maybe you don't often see and you overlook. And then after that, there should still be some time for a little discussion. So the discussions are really chances for you to bring forward anything that came up for you or that wasn't clear, or anything you'd just like to offer, share, clarify doubts around, or complaints. If I say something really off, then you have to pick me up on that, okay? Otherwise I'll get conceited. We don't want that in any Buddhist teacher. Okay, so we'll begin with the Buddha's words on loving kindness, and in Pali that is the Karaniya Metta Sutta. This is what should be done by one who is skilled in goodness and who knows the path of peace. Let them be able and upright, straightforward and gentle. Contented and easy. I'm quite impressed. Start the guided meditation now. And please take these words of guidance just as an offering. If you're used to practicing your own way, then please go ahead with that. But I'll just introduce a way to enter the meditation, making kindness the most important thing. So in meditation, what we're aware of is not so crucial, but the way that we're aware of it makes the difference. So we learn how to develop wise attitude, right intention in the practice itself. So just finding a comfortable position, closing the eyes, unless you prefer to keep the eyes closed, just find whatever feels right for you. Giving yourself time to settle into your seat or onto your cushion. And attending to the body. Allowing the body to guide what you decide to do, how you decide to sit, rather than trying to control the body. Find it helpful to straighten the spine just a little. Other people prefer to lean against the back of the chair. Or even allow yourself to slouch if you need to do that. The body will adjust itself naturally during the meditation. Welcoming yourself to this space which is shared with everybody else, your friends in the Dhamma, who've all come here with only one intention, to offer themselves a gift of silence, a break from the busyness of the world. Having settled all your duties, notice how it feels to have nothing in the world to do. No one's measuring or judging you. There's nothing to get right. See if you can tune in to the beauty of having time, space with nothing to do, and the beautiful silence of this room. Noticing the relief of putting everything down. If it helps you to arrive a little bit more fully, Just take a slightly deeper breath than you're used to taking. And notice the sensation of releasing that breath, bringing deeper relaxation to the body and to the mind. Maybe breathing in this way 3 or 4 times as you settle more fully into this moment. At the beginning of the meditation, once you settle, we establish an attitude of kindness, of openness, of curiosity. Allowing nature to manifest in whatever way it wishes. It's not our job to control the experience. Our only work is to learn how to relate with a kind, open, and soft heart to whatever arises in this present moment. If it helps, you may use your imagination. Bring up the image or the feeling of a person, perhaps a Buddha, who represents kindness and compassion to you. Perhaps, if not a Buddha, there's somebody in your life who you feel very safe around. Unjudged and regarded kindly whenever you're in their presence. Or perhaps this might be an experience that you've had in nature. Whatever helps conjure up that feeling of safety, kindness, relaxation. Now bringing that same attitude of kindness and gentleness to become aware of your own body, of any sensations in the body. Regarding them with kindly eyes. Allowing them to guide you more deeply, more fully into this present moment. Find any areas of tightness or tension. See what kind of awareness is needed to just soften into that, to relax the tension. As though you were caressing or cradling a small child. You can mentally caress that area with kindness and gentleness. Listening deeply. Maintaining a very kind and open attitude, an attitude of warmth and respect. See if the breath would like to enter your awareness. If the breath wants to come in, allow it to do so. Welcoming each little breath. So it was a very special friend you haven't seen for a long time. But giving that breath permission to stay or leave as it likes. So grateful that one breath has come to visit me. Noticing the simple beauty of one little breath. Without trying to pull the breath in or hold onto it, allowing it to come in and leave as it likes. See if you can find contentment in the breath. As each breath helps you to soften and deepen more fully into each moment. Calming, soothing, stilling the mind. every experience with the compassionate, kindly eyes of a Buddha. Before we end the meditation, while your eyes are still closed, I'd like to invite you to reflect on how you feel now compared with how you felt at the beginning of the practice. Do you feel a little bit more relaxed or peaceful? And if so, why? What was the cause of developing peace? Or if the mind is agitated, what were the causes for that agitation? Did you want to be somewhere else with a different experience? Or was this moment good enough? and just taking a moment to offer yourself gratitude for giving yourself this gift, the time, the space, the silence, and the companionship of people interested in practicing the path. Really appreciating that good intention. And sharing any peace and harmony that you developed with everyone in this room, with all beings. May all beings develop peace, wisdom, and happiness. May they all be free from suffering. I'll ring the bell, and at the end of the third ringing, if you wish, you can open your eyes.